Located in the middle of Florida's Northwest Panhandle is Calhoun County. With 574 square miles of rural lands that include two rivers, numerous historical sites, and established communities with folks that adhere to the Southern traditions of hospitality, this collection of diversity in landscapes and people is more than just a dot on the map. Calhoun County residents are dedicated in sharing a rich heritage while not forgetting traditional values. The quaint communities of Bluntstown, Alpha, and surrounding establishments are ready to welcome visitors that share their love of the great outdoors. Tucked away in the panhandle of Florida, just over an hour from the Gulf of Mexico, Calhoun County is located right in the center of everything Northwest Florida has to offer.
John Blunt founded the first county seat, Iola, in Calhoun County, and he founded Bluntstown here, who later became the main county seat of Calhoun County.
One of the main things I found upon arriving at Calhoun County was a tremendous amount of business opportunities available here.
This area is a wonderful area to do business in. The small community adds a lot to it.
Well, Calhoun County is very friendly to the timber business because there's such large timber bases that surround Calhoun County. So it's always been a pleasure to work in the timber industry here.
Calhoun County has a group of people that are willing to work. They're hungry for work, and I believe if the opportunity was given to them, they would excel at any job that they were offered.
In our rural atmosphere of Calhoun County, we do want to hang on to our past, which is the M&B Railroad. Having the theme of small town Bluntstown and small town Alpha, we have to have that, but we still have to move forward and prosper.
People came into town, they'll stop, they'll walk the streets, shop in the shops, and just generate a little more money, income for the local economy, and plus promoting Calhoun County and Bluntstown.
Calhoun County is a great place to raise children. It holds its rural values, and we have pride in our county.
Calhoun County is a loving place. When you go through some tragedy, when you get people that will reach out and they'll help you up, they'll encourage you.
Calhoun Counties are known for is their graciousness toward one another. I think they'll people that come in have been and will be accepted by the community.
This is a beautiful county. We have a lot of advantages that other places don't have, and there's a lot of recreation, and the people are good people.
I think at the end of the day, what we really want is just a good place to live, and that's what Calhoun County is.
Before we go any further, our local historian and writer, Mr. George Atkins, will give us a history lesson about Calhoun County.
Calhoun County was created in 1838. It was named after the South Carolina United States Senator, John C. Calhoun, who was serving under President Quincy Adams and Andrew Jackson. The county was created in order to establish St. Joseph as a commercial competitor to Apalachicola. St. Joseph flourished for only a few years. During this time, the city served as the county seat for Calhoun County. A railroad was constructed from St. Joseph to Iola on the west bank of the Apalachicola River. Thousands of bales of cotton were diverted from the seaport of Apalachicola over the railroad to St. Joseph to be shipped to England. From 1840 until 1860, cotton growing became a very lucrative business for Calhoun County farmers. The war between the states brought an end to the planter life. Calhoun County, as well as other cotton-growing areas, ceased to exist as well-to-do communities. The county showed little growth from 1865 to 1890. Timber and the naval store industry became the money-making industry by the turn of the century. The large cypress trees, many of them over 300 years old, were cut from the swamps and rafted and floated down the Chipola and Apalachicola rivers to the huge sawmills at the mouth of the river. In 1902, a movement began to build a new courthouse a mile north and west of the river town. In May of 1903, the present city of Bluntstown was chartered. Calhoun County became one of the fastest growing counties in Florida from 1910 to 1920. large corporate sawmills moved into the county during this decade. In 1917, Neal Lumber and Manufacturing Company moved into Old Bluntstown and acquired 70,000 acres of hardwood timberland. Calhoun Countyans believed in public education. By the early 1920s, four high schools were built in the county: Fort St. Joe, Wewahitchka, Bluntstown, and Alpha, and later Frank and Kynard built brick buildings in their particular area. Before 1920, as many as 30 district schools accommodated the pupils in small communities.
We have many strong points in Calhoun County school system. Over the years, it's had a very rich history of strong academics, programs, our commitment to our students. We have strong parent and community involvement, and we continue to have this rich tradition.
One of the best school systems in the state of Florida, plus the United States. We got good teachers, very personal.
Calhoun County, Bluntstown in particular, lays equidistant from Tallahassee, which is a major metropolitan area, Panama City, another major area, and then Dothan laying to the north of us. So basically, in any distance you go for 1 hour's travel, you can be in a major city.
I can go to a movie, I can go to the symphony, I can do all of that in an hour or less. It may be 60 miles away.
So this is just kind of a really laid back area, kind of community where people can raise their kids and enjoy life and not have the hustle and bustle and the problems that you have in larger places.
I just kind of love to live here. It's easy living, you know, kind of slow paced.
Because of its ruralness, you have a much slower pace for life, but you've got the richness of having the ability to know your neighbors.
People are seeing things differently. And while they're holding on to the past, they're also looking to the future.
The sense of pride that we now have that I didn't see a few years ago. The sense of being that we want to be here, that we finally realize that there is value here.
And I love it because most of the people here have always been here. I love the people that move in here too, because when they first come, they'll walk into the store and I say, well, good morning. They'll walk right by me and they won't even speak back to me. And after about speaking to them about 10 to 15 times, then they'll start, well, hello, how are you?
It's just a great thing to see where, you know, everybody's your neighbor. And when you go to the Piggly Wiggly, everyone is there to say good morning or smile and wave at you. And that is just how our atmosphere is in Calhoun County.
I had never been to Calhoun County in my life. But the moment I came to Calhoun County, I soon knew what I wanted to do here. Our goals here at Main Street Station Restaurant are to give the folks of Calhoun County and the Northwest Florida area in general an outlet to come, enjoy themselves, enjoy a nice meal, talk and commune and just have a good time.
In the jewelry business, it's very, very important that you have good employees, that you, the trustworthy employees, and we've been blessed to have some real good, trustworthy employees here at the Diamond Corner.
Industry helps us out in so many different ways. It provides jobs for the people that are here, and it brings income in, helps with taxes. So, I mean, it's something that we have to have. And the workforce and everything is ready for it and primed.
In this 5-county area, the Chipola Workforce Board, and they do a wonderful job in providing training for our county as well as the other counties in this area. We've also benefited from the Enterprise Zone when we added on a new greenhouse and when we've done some other expansion in this area.
When you compare the growth potential of in the agricultural product side of the timber business, to the growth potential in Calhoun County of the land is so much superior to the deeper sands that really are east and west of Calhoun County. The productivity of this land in as it relates to timber has been, you know, a key thing with Neal Land and Timber. And that's what the land in Calhoun County has enabled us to do.
For an existing business, I really think it's more than just than making money. I think any business in our community makes a real investment in the lives of our children, the lives of our citizens. When you come to Calhoun County to do business, or if you're doing business in Calhoun County, I honestly feel like it is really very important that you know each day it affects someone in each way. And in Calhoun County, that's very important.
You could always go to businesses and you could ask for the things that you need, and the servers are really, they help you, they talk to you. And then they talk their hometown talk, and it's a good place to have a business.
We need to maintain the green spaces that we have. I see us using what we have as far as the rivers, the green space, more in an ecotourism type of business industry in this area. I think that we could really benefit from that. That will also provide jobs for our families and all that have grown up in this area that enjoy the green spaces and look forward to keeping them green.
The city has an excellent trail system. It is probably one of the cornerstones to Bluntstown, Bluntstown Trailway. We're looking at ways to improve upon that trail system.
Also, we have wonderful water here. I think that's another big, big issue for people who move into the panhandle, is that we have a great aquifer. So those are things that I see that are good for business and good for Calhoun County.
And we've got 5 or 6 businesses here in Bluntstown that will be opening up over the next year. And a lot of the shops that have been closed up for a long time downtown are now seeing new owners and new shops coming in, and a lot of young bloods moving in and new ideas. And it really is taking off. And I think that's something we have to look forward to. And I want to see, when people talk about Calhoun County, and I want to see that gleam in their eye and that smile on their face where they're happy to be from Calhoun County. Things are happening there, and they're proud of the history also.
We give all these facts and figures to new projects coming into town. We look at the data and the market information and everything, but when it really gets down to it, for a new business to be in Calhoun County, it really is about the quality of life.
A new business and all could prosper here. The workforce, I believe, is here. And so I would say, yes, come on, and let's grow together.
If you have a small business and want to come to Calhoun County, we got a lot of people here that are willing to work with you, from realtors to banking and to local organizations, civic organizations, and we're here to help, and we'd like to see you come.
The purpose of the Calhoun County Chamber of Commerce is to provide community leadership and resources dedicated to supporting existing businesses, creating new jobs, promoting our community, and enhancing education. For more information, contact Calhoun County Chamber of Commerce at 850-674-4519 or at www.calhounco.org.